Hi, my name is Kylie, and welcome to The Planets 3. In this video, you'll learn about the last two planets and why Pluto isn't really a planet. After Saturn, the last planet you learned about in the previous video, comes the seventh planet from the Sun. Uranus. Uranus is one of the least understood planets in our entire solar system. It has two sets of very thin, dark rings and has a total of 27 moons. Its moons are frozen and very cold. Uranus is an ice giant and is made up of gases and ice crystals. The ice crystals are not ice made of water. They are ice crystals of ammonia and methane. Two gases that are so cold on Uranus, they freeze. The methane gas is why Uranus appears a beautiful light blue color. If the methane wasn't frozen, it sure would stink. If you've ever been by a herd of cattle, you may know what methane smells like. Uranus is very cold and has a near constant temperature of negative 357 degrees Fahrenheit. Uranus orbits around the Sun every 84 years and is almost 2 billion miles away from the Sun. A day on Uranus lasts 17 hours. Uranus is also about 4 times bigger than the Earth, but its gravity is a little weaker. As a result, if you weighed 100 pounds on Earth, you would only weigh about 88 pounds on Uranus. NASA has only flown one spacecraft, Voyager 2, past Uranus. No craft has ever gone into its atmosphere or orbited it to get a better look. The eighth and last official planet from the Sun is Neptune. Neptune is dark blue in color and it may appear like it is covered in water. However, there isn't a drop to be found because Neptune is considered to be an ice giant. That blue color isn't from water. It is also from frozen methane like Uranus. It is about 2.8 billion miles from the Sun. A year on Neptune lasts 165 Earth years, and a day on Neptune lasts about 16 hours. Neptune is also about 4 times the size of Earth. It has 13 moons, and scientists are currently discussing if there is a 14th one. We now know Neptune has 6 rings, but we do not yet know what they are made up of. Neptune is known as the windiest planet, with ice gas winds blowing up to 1,200 miles per hour. That's as fast as some fighter jets fly. Earth's fastest winds reach only about 250 miles per hour during its strongest storms. With the wind whipping and being so far from the Sun, Neptune's temperatures stay at about 365 degrees negative Fahrenheit. With Neptune's gravity pull being slightly stronger than Earth's, a 100-pound person would weigh 112 pounds. We can't forget about Pluto. Pluto was discovered in 1930, and it was considered a planet up until 2006. As astronomy has improved since 1930, with better telescopes and the invention of spacecraft that eventually made it to Pluto to study it in more depth, scientists decided to change Pluto's classification from a planet to a dwarf planet. This had to do with Pluto's orbit. For an object to be considered to be a planet in our solar system, it must meet 3 criteria or tests. Pluto meets the first 2 criteria, which are that it must orbit the Sun and it must have enough gravity to rotate and pull itself into a sphere or ball. The third test is orbit. A planet must only orbit the Sun and nothing else. Pluto actually orbits the Sun and another object. This newly discovered object is named Eris, which is also a dwarf planet. Even though Pluto is no longer considered one of the main planets of our solar system, it is still really interesting to study. First of all, Pluto has very little gravity. If you weighed 100 pounds on Earth, you would only weigh 6.7 pounds on Pluto. That is about the weight of a small human baby. Pluto is really small and thought to be made of mostly ice. The ice on the surface of Pluto is made of frozen nitrogen, methane, and carbon monoxide. It probably has a small rocky core, which might contain some metals. Pluto is about 3/4 of the size of our moon. Even though it is so small, Pluto has 5 of its own moons. Pluto is about 3.7 billion miles from the Sun and takes 248 Earth years to equal one of its own years. That is one long trip around the Sun. A day on Pluto takes an Earth week, or 6.4 days. Pluto is by far the coldest of the planets or dwarf planets, with a temperature range of between negative 400 to negative 360 degrees Fahrenheit. We know a little more about Pluto than the other planets because NASA sent a spacecraft there. On July 14, 2015, the New Horizons craft began to hover in orbit above Pluto. Its mission is to collect data, or information, about Pluto and one of its moons, Charon. It will try to map the surfaces of both of them, as well as take temperatures, samples, and other measurements. We have just went through a lot of amazing facts about the last few planets and Pluto. We've taken a journey through them one by one, and I hope you've enjoyed the journey. Remember, this is the last video we have about the planets. If you missed the first two videos, you can check out Planets 1 and the Planets 2. Be sure to go back and watch them and learn about the first 6 planets in the solar system. If you like to learn about astronomy, which is the study of outer space, check out our other astronomy videos and games. Remember to always be clever.